Running this company has been quite a journey. It started out, I think, as opposed to many other startups, that we had three really, really good years. It was like a rocket in the beginning because we were alone on the market the first, at least the first 6 months. So when we got an ad in the paper, we went like from 500 customers to 1,000 almost overnight. But then we hit competition, and it was really, really tough. And by then we had a cost structure that was over dimensioned for the according to our size, so that we really had to adjust to the new circumstances. So it's been tough, also.
And how is it right now?
It's looking good.
How has it been having a business? Was it as easy from the start to the till where you are right now?
Well, actually, I think for us, our startup was a little bit different than a lot of companies. We had our first 3 years, we rocketed. I mean, we grew so quickly that we didn't even have time to sell. And that's a very positive problem, I think, for an entrepreneur. But then after like 3 years, we hit very, very rough competition. So now we have to work hard just like all other companies.
Tell me about your business idea.
We offer home delivery of ready-plan grocery bags with everything you need to make, say, 5 dinners for 4 people, all the ingredients and also the recipes to match.
How did you come up with the idea?
That's a long story, but I did see a lot of people struggling around me, and I was at that stage in my life where my kids were very small and they got hungry about, you know, 5:30, and I wanted to have them to have good food on the table. And I've always had a big interest in food, or at least since I was 18, but a lot of my friends and also the greater circle of friends were really struggling with this. And I saw that there was a need in the market, and I had something, I could give them something that they needed.
The idea was born of you not having enough time, but now you have your business that you're running, you're blogging, you're the face of your company. Do you have more time?
Well, it wasn't really that it was more to free up time for other people. The service that I offer wasn't maybe the service that I myself needed, but I saw that other people needed it.
Okay. You created this food concept. Talk to me about the growth of the company. What pitfalls or obstacles have you been had to overcome?
Well, I think it's hard to prepare for the kind of competition that we ran into in our third year. And I think we started to think that this growth that we were experiencing will just continue no matter what we do. But I have realized, I think maybe the hard way, that you can never lean back and feel like now we have a good idea that's up and running by itself. So we have to continuously improve our product, improve our service, improve everything that we offer to be able to play this game with this competition so we can offer the best possible service compared to our competitors.
What's the next step for me, Frida?
Well, it's to grow and to keep find even smarter ways of simplifying cooking in people's homes so that people can eat better.
And you work together with your husband, who is the CEO. How is it working with him?
Working with your husband is something that I never believed in before we did it. And people have warned us about that this is going to kill the passion in your marriage and don't do it, don't go there. But I can say that it has so many upsides that people never talk about. And just the flexibility of we can decide what we want to do. I know what he has on his schedule for today, and he knows what I have on mine, so we never have to fight about who stays home with the kids if they're sick. So it has so many advantages as well. It's fun to do business together. I'm interested in the food quality questions, food politics, and he's interested in building a company, making it grow, sales, partnership. So we never fight about the different tasks. We have our roles perfectly clear.
What are the three elements of success according to you?
Well, the most important thing is to sell all the time. And even from the very, very start, I say this to new people starting up new businesses, that they need to spend at least 50% of their time on sales. And that could be PR, that could be picking up the phone, it could be standing down at the mall telling people about your product. But you have to continuously talk about your product all the time. That's key. And then I think passion, doing what you really love doing and that you do well. That's number two. Number three, just I guess plain old hard work every day.
What does the future hold for Medasfrid?
Well, I think the future is bright for us because I think that the awareness about food quality and what we're putting into our bodies is increasing in Sweden and in other countries as well. And we want to be a part of that and to contribute to people's better eating habits.
Is this a very Swedish way to run a business?
Well, I think the fact that we're addressing many problems in one service, we help people not only with the menu planning, but also maybe make them feel a little less guilty because they're giving their children a better varied diet. They can think about global warming. They don't have to do that. We do that for them. And also we're freeing up time that used to be, with work that used to be done in the homes, now is put on a private company, which I think is typical for Swedish. We're a very equal society where men and women do share the work at home. And the Swedish market is considered a very good test market because since we're considered early adopters. So maybe this is very Swedish, I really don't know.
Are there options for every budget?
Well, we offer our services. You want our bags weekly or every second week or every third week. Or we have a smaller bag. We have options where you get help 3 nights of the week. We have options where you get help all weekdays with 5 dinners for 4 people. So we have a variety. But it is all high quality food. We're not the cheapest, but we think we're the most prize-worthy. We don't sell food. We sell a life quality enhancing service where planning is a key factor. And you can't even buy the products in our bag in a store because some of the packages are especially tailored for our bag with the exact amount needed. We can send one organic lemon, but at the store you might have to buy a whole bag. So it's not really possible to compare that way.
What about the waste when you cook? How much is wasted?
Well, we've asked our customers, and they estimate their waste to be between 0% and 5%. And we know that the average in Sweden is 20% to 40%, because our bags are so well planned down to the nitty gritty detail that very, very little is wasted.
So you're growing abroad. You have Medasfrid in different countries. How do you adopt your concept, your Swedish concept, into Canada? How do you work with the name, with the recipes,
well,
culture?
We've cooperated with local entrepreneurs in most places. So the name, it's hard for us to hear what goes with that population. But I think in general, it's trial and error, see what works. In Belgium, for example, our small bag for 2 people is the most popular, because I think families tend to go more to restaurants than they do in Sweden. Here we don't go with our family to restaurants, we eat at home. And those little cultural differences make a bigger difference than you might think.
What is it called in Canada?
Dinner It.
How does it work there?
Well, we just started up there, so it's a little early to say.
Where have you been running your business for a while? In what country?
Germany.
Can you tell me a little bit about the differences between Swedish market and German market?
When we started up in Germany, with its huge population, we thought that sales would just rocket straight away, but we found that it wasn't as easy as we had thought. The German women, it seems, are expected to have food ready for their children when they come home from school at 1 o'clock in the middle of the day, and then like go back to work after that. So taking these like household chores and putting them on an external company has been more difficult, or a little more radical, or that's at least what we think makes it harder to sell this product in Germany, or we're not at that point where everyone knows about it and everyone is positive towards it. In Sweden, on the other hand, we have a very equal, we have a high quality between men and women. This has been very, no one has even brought this up as an argument that this would be wrong to let someone else do, as it has, for example, cleaning services. To prioritize my time is a challenge, has always been, but it was easier from the beginning because I did everything myself. It was only me, and then it was me and my husband, and then it was me and these 2 other employees. So my job has actually changed every 6 months. I have a new job. Now though, when I have 28 people here, I can basically do what I want, what I think is fun. And that creates so much opportunity, that makes it even trickier.
How important is it to network?
Oh, I think it's very important to network in all stages of the company development. The first year, for example, we had no money for marketing. So my husband and I, we collected as many email addresses to friends and our former bosses, former colleagues, maybe their families and our own families and their friends, and spread word by email about our new service. And all of a sudden we had, from the very, very beginning, we had like 150 customers, where we had counted on 60. So it really makes a difference to just get out there and network and use your friends. They will help you.
When you recruit, how do you choose people?
Well, when we recruit people, we've tried so many different ways, and it depends a little bit on the role. When it comes to people with computer skills, it's very difficult to find good people because most of them want to be as consultants, and we've had to pay very much to get them, and sometimes we've had to try people that we might not have believed in. We've had to take a higher risk. Other roles are very, very easy to fill, and we've used channels like Twitter, Facebook, just our own personal networks, in many different ways.
How do you recruit managers leading positions?
When we need to recruit a manager, there are two aspects that we think about, and that is not only do they need to be a good boss for their own teams that they're going to lead, but also that they fit into the managerial team with their personality and character strengths. So we have a wide, we get a wider perspective in running the company.
What has been the biggest challenge going into this business?
The competition, I think, has been the biggest challenge. It was so unexpected and it's so, so powerful. But for the customer, if you look at it from the customer's point of view, it's really good for the customers because it makes us really, really work hard every day to stay on top.
You don't do that much marketing. How do you get customers if you don't do?
We work with social media. And also our startups abroad also bring in money because they pay us to help them start up these companies. So that's also an income that our competitors might not have.